We are gathered here to fulfill the requirement of the law in furtherance to accountability and transparency.
The Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, joined the other 34,000 government officials, including political leaders, appointed leaders and civil servants, who must declare their wealth as per the law. Speaker Anita Among's declaration of wealth was witnessed by the Inspector General of Government Duties, Dr. Patricia Achan Okiria and Mrs. Antwino Mugisha Muhaire. Among called for deeper investigations into declaration of wealth in order to attach the right wealth to an individual.
I don't see why people should continue hiding whatever they have in other people's name. If I have a property which is in my name, it is mine. And if I can account for where it came from, I should be able to do that. The quest of accountability is very, very important in good governance. If we can be able to make sure that we make everybody accountable for what he or she has, will be reducing corruption.
She also implored all legislators and staff to follow suit and heed the legal requirements to enhance transparency.
I will also request the members of parliament and the staff of parliament and civil servants, public servants, to do the same. Declare your assets, your income and your liabilities so that we know what we have. Who has what?
The Inspector General of Government Duties, Dr. Patricia Achan Okiria, and Mrs. Antwino Mugisha Muhaire also declared their wealth and uploaded their boss Betty Kamia's wealth on the online system, witnessed by the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, as required by the law.
We are here as leaders of the Inspectorate of Government to declare our incomes, assets and liabilities to you, the Speaker of Parliament, as required by Section 31(7) of the Leadership Code Act. We have to be walking the talk, we have to walk in the light and encourage leaders out there to declare their assets, their incomes and liabilities.
Okiria said that the declaration of wealth by leaders is a vital tool in preventing corruption, detecting illicit enrichment and conflict of interest.
It also helps us to be able to monitor and ensure that all entrusted power and authority vested upon leaders and public servants is not abused. And therefore, Right Honorable Speaker, we are here basically to fulfill that constitutional obligation, and we are going to continue creating more awareness out there so that all the leaders get to know their responsibility.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.